advantage. Okay, so first part is a construction of a DC motor or DC machine. Okay, so as you can see right from this figure, so this figure is divided into different parts. The outer part of this motor, DC motor, is called a stator. Okay, and the inner part is called as a rotor, or you can see from this stator part, this outer peripheral. Okay, this outer peripheral is a stator. Inside this, there are pole and shoe or a face, and in these pole, shoes or face, we can place some winding, field winding. And what is this field winding? Field winding is a your input winding, where you have to provide the current through this winding. Okay, then inside this we have to place some armature core. Okay, and inside this armature core we have to place some bearing, shaft and commutators. Okay, and we have to provide all these with the brushes. The connections is provided with the help of this brushes, and this armature winding is placed inside this armature core. Okay, so there are different parts. First is the magnetic frame or yoke. Okay, second one is a pole core or pole shoes. Third one is a magnetic field or exciting coils. Fourth one is armature core, armature winding, then commutator, brushes, bearings, end ring and shaft. Okay, so you have seen all these rotations right here. So outer part is called a stator. Inside this stator we have to place some poles, shoe or faces. Inside these poles we have to place some winding, that is called a field winding. Okay, and inside this stator we have to place this armature core. In armature core we have to place armature winding, and with the help of this winding this shaft is rotating, and this shaft is placed on some bearing, commutator and brushes. Okay, are connected to this shaft. Everyone understood about the construction part of this DC machine? Quickly give your response. Any doubt related to the construction part? Quickly. Okay, now come to the next part. Okay, so come to the next part. This is the internal diagram of your DC machine. Okay, so the internal diagram is shown right here. Okay, so this is the outer part. Outer part is called, as you can see, this is the outer part. Okay, so this outer part is known as a stator part. Okay, so this is a stator. So from this diagram, first understand the notations, how we can denote the every part of this motor. Okay, so this is the field winding. So field windings are nothing but that winding which are provided to the input supply. So this input supply is provided to these field windings. Okay, so these field windings are placed on the pole shoe. Okay, okay, so this pole shoe is used for the placing of field winding. Okay, so properly you can see this, that this is a south pole, then north pole, then south pole and north pole. So these pole shoe are represented in alternate way. Okay, south, north, south and north. Okay, then we have to use some interpole. So interpoles are also connected to this winding. Okay, so these windings are connected to the some rotatory part. Okay, so they are alternative, like north, then south, then north, then south. Okay, so after that we have to connect these with commutators. So here is the commutator part. This is the commutator part. This one is a commutator part. Clear? So this commutator is present inside your rotor because here is the rotation of the particular motor. Okay, so this commutator is present inside your rotatory part. Okay, then there is a frame. So where is the, where this frame comes? This frame is present on the stator part. Okay, then we have to place some armature conductors. So where we have to place these armature conductors? These armature conductors are placed inside your rotor. So these are the armature conductors. Okay, these are the armature conductors. Now when you apply some field, okay, using a rheostat, this is a positive terminal, this is the negative terminal. So this supply goes directly to your field winding. Okay, so field winding are placed right here, and this positive is going to this interpole winding right here. Okay, so the connection is completed at this position, and the field generates the magnetic field right here, and the same working principle is applied right here. Okay, and this rotor will rotate at this point of time. So Gautam is asking a question that use of interpole. So Gautam, we will discuss all these terms in detail. Just right now you understand the working, you understand the construction part. Okay, so we will discuss all these points in detail. Okay, so have you understood how to construct a DC motor? Have you understand what we call each part of a DC motor? So if this is clear, then we will move toward the working part. Okay, so construction part is completed. Now Parth is saying that repeat once again. Okay Parth, I will repeat once again. So first is a DC motor. What is a DC motor? DC motor is a direct current motor. Okay, so what do you mean by direct current? Direct current means this is the simple diagram for the small size DC motor and large size DC motor. Okay, so what are the different part of a DC motor? We have explained in this slide. So the different part of a DC motors are magnetic frame or yoke. Just relate this DC motor with your induction motor. Okay, the outer part of the motor in case of three phase induction motor is called a stator, and inner part of a three phase induction motor is called a rotor. But in case of this DC motor, the outer part of this motor is called the stator, whereas the inner part is called as a, what we call it as, let's, here is a armature. Okay, so this is a armature. Clear? So in the outer part you have to connect magnetic frames or yokes. Okay, so this is the outer part. We have to connect here the magnetic frames or yoke. Okay, and on that magnetic frames and yokes we have to provide the pole core and pole shoes. So on that pole core and pole shoes we have to place magnetic these winding. Okay, field winding we have to place over these poles and cores. Okay, then magnetic field and exciting coil is placed over these poles. Okay, then armature core, the inner part of this DC motor is called armature Okay, so this armature core is present inside your stator part. Okay, and over this armature core, we have to place this armature winding. So with the help of this winding, magnetic field will be induced and shaft will rotate. Okay, so this shaft is connected through bearing, okay, through commutator and brushes. Okay, so this is the simple construction of a DC motor. Okay, now come to the inner part of a DC motor. So in the inner part, how we can connect this DC motor? As you can see, this is the outer portion. In this outer portion, just relate this outer portion with three-phase induction motor. In three-phase induction motor, we have a stator and rotor part, but right here, this outer part is connected with the winding over a pole shoe. Okay, so what is pole shoe? This south, north, south, north. These are pole shoes. On this pole shoe, we have to provide the filled winding. So what is the filled winding? Filled winding is nothing but it's a input supply is provided to these winding. Okay, so when you apply input supply to these winding, magnetic field will be induced right here. Okay, so with the help of that magnetic field, our internal this armature is moving. Okay, so this is pole, then we are using interpole. Interpole is used to change the direction of a motor. Okay, then commutator is present inside this rotatory part. Okay, then frame is the outer part of this motor. Armature conductor, generally we use this armature conductor to generate the force. Okay, to generate the rotation part right here. Okay, with the help of these conductor, this rotor is rotating. Okay, then field rheostat. So to generate the constant voltage supply right from here, we use this rheostat. Okay, then positive and negative terminal is connected to these field winding. So part, have you understood all these parts? Quickly give your response. Construction part is clear to all. Quickly give your response. Sir, commutator rotate or it hold the rotor part? So this is as you can see from the figure, this is the commutator. So commutator is a part which is placed on your shaft. Okay, this shaft is moving. But have you understood? Commutator is used over the shaft. Okay, as you can see from this diagram, I just see this diagram. I will increase the size of this diagram. Right now you can see what is the rotatory part. Only this shaft is rotating. Okay, and this commutator is placed over this shaft. Okay, then bearing is used. Clear? Brushes are also used. We will discuss all these parts in detail. Okay, we will discuss all these parts in detail. So till now you understand how to connect this DC motor with different parts. Clear? Everyone clear? Quickly give your response. Then we will move toward the next. Okay, okay. So presentation is visible to you all or not? Quickly give your response. So we have Yes, okay. So presentation is visible. Okay, no problem. Now let's come to the next point. We have discussed this DC motor's internal diagram. Now come to the next point. The outer hollow cylindrical frame, or which is the main poles and interpoles, are fixed, and by means of which the machine is fixed to the foundation is known as yoke. Just relate it with your three-phase induction motor. So in case of three-phase induction motor, the outer part is called a stator, where in case of DC motor, the outer part is called as a yoke. Okay. The main purpose of the yoke is as follows. So we have seen the three-phase induction motor. Generally, stator is used to hold the winding, okay, hold the three-phase induction motor. So in case of this DC motor, the main purpose is it supports the pole core and provide a mechanical protection to the inner part of a machine. Okay, it provides a low reluctance path for the magnetic flux. So what do you mean by low reluctance path? Quickly give your response. Low reluctance path means it has a low resistance. So we are using R and L, okay? So that's why the term reluctance is present in case of this DC motor, okay? Allow easy flow of flux. Gautam, yes, you are right. Allow easy flow of flux. So this is the main purpose of this yoke. So in case of three-phase induction motor, this yoke is called as a stator. Okay, just relate it with three-phase induction motor. In three-phase induction motor, the outer part is called stator, where in case of DC motor, the outer part is called yoke. Okay. Now, pole and core or pole shoes. The pole core and pole shoes are fixed to the magnetic frame or yoke by bolts. Okay, so these are placed over the magnetic frames, okay, with the bolts. So you can see the figure of this. This is the figure, okay. With the help of this figure, you will understand so how to connect these bolts. So here is the magnetic pole core, okay. You have to place these bolts with these tiny holes, okay. So we have to place the rivet over these holes, and these poles are placed over the field. Okay, so this is the top hole for the fixing. This is the rivet. This is the sections for the field coil. Then we have to provide some laminated pole core over there. Then laminated pole shoes are also provided over this. Okay, clear? Now, the pole core and shoes are made with thin casting or iron laminations. So what is the material used for this pole core? Cast steel and iron lamination. Okay, it supports the field or exciting coils. They spread out the magnetic flux over the armature periphery more uniformly. It increases the cross-sectional area of the magnetic circuit, and result the reluctance of the magnetic path is reduced. Okay, so its main advantage is that it increases the cross-sectional area of the magnetic circuit. Okay, so that will result the reluctance of a magnetic path is reduced. Okay, the opposition to the magnetic flow is reduced in this case. Clear? Everyone understood about this? Now come to the next, field or exciting coil. So what is the field? You can see from this figure, this is the field. So this field contains different parts. What are those? First one is a wire end. So these are the wire end. These are directly connected to your power supply. Okay. Then there are formers. Then field winding is placed inside these. Okay, clear? So formers are placed, and windings are placed inside it, and these wires are connected to the power supply. So these are called exciting coils. Okay, clear? Now come to the next, armature winding. So what is armature winding? The insulating conductors are placed inside in slot of armature core. The armature winding is the heart of a DC machine. Okay, armature winding is placed where the conversions of power take place. The winding are classified into two types, name as lap winding or wave winding. So what is lap winding? In lap winding, the conductors are connected in such a way that number of parallel paths are equal to number of poles. Okay, and wave winding. In wave winding, the conductors are so connected that they are divided into two parallel irrespective of the number of the poles of the machine. Okay, so Parth is asking a question, sir, what is use of former? So the former in this case, sir, what is use of this in above class? Okay, so this is former. The surface of your plate, okay, the surface of your plate which is insulated with some material, okay, so this is the plain surface of number of plates. So they are insulated together to remove the hysteresis as well as the eddy current losses or reluctance, to remove the reluctance. Okay, so this former is a plain surface of the plate. Okay, we have to place some insulating material over that, and we have to join these number of plates together. So they are not in a single piece. We have to place number of plates with the help of insulation. Okay, and over there we have to provide the filled winding. So Parth, have you understood this? What is this former? Former means, okay, so this is one plate, and we have to connect these n number of plates with the insulation. Okay, so with the help of insulation you can join number of plates, and over these plates we have to provide the winding. Okay, so with the help of those winding, magnetic fields will be induced. Okay, so it will reduce your reluctance and also reduce your hysteresis as well as eddy current losses. Okay, so we will discuss this DC machine working principle in the next session. Okay, so today's session is up to the armature construction part. We will discuss all the construction part today. Okay, working we will discuss in the next lecture. So Rituraj Raman is asking a question, former is a plate or frame for winding. So Rituraj, let's understand with the help of this whiteboard. Okay, so this is your plate, this is your one plate. Okay, have you seen the transformer? So same concept is applied here. So have you seen the induction motor? Same working principle or same construction is applied right here. Okay, so in case of transformer, when you connect different plates, like here there are different plates. I am giving this example because we have covered the transformer as well as 3-phase induction motor. Okay, so that's why I am giving this example to you. So this is the transformer. Okay, here we have to join number of plates. So we will provide primary winding across this side, and we will provide secondary winding across this side. Okay, this is the formation of your transformer. This is primary side and this is secondary side. Here we can connect the load, and here we can connect the input supply. Let's take an example of your 3-phase induction motor. So this is the 3-phase induction motor stator frame. Okay, here we have to connect n number of frames. So this is one frame, so we have to connect n number of frames. Okay, we have to connect n number of frames right from here. So this is one frame, this is the second frame. So these frames are to be connected with the help of some insulation. Okay, so why are you using these number of plates? Why you cannot use single plate for the winding, for the placing of winding? Rituraj, give the answer. To reduce eddy current loss, Gautam is saying, to reduce the eddy current loss. Yes Gautam, you are right, to reduce the eddy current loss. So we are placing these winding right here. So this plate is not a single piece plate. We are placing these plates with the help of some insulating materials. So same process is followed in case of DC motor. So you have this plate, and this plate is not a single plate. We have to place n number of plates with the help of some insulation. Okay, and over these plates we have to place the winding. So Gautam is saying that to reduce the eddy current loss and hysteresis loss, these number of plates are used. Okay, so Rituraj, have you understood this? Former is a plate or frame for the winding. So these are the number of plates which are used to place the winding to reduce eddy current loss, hysteresis loss, and reluctance. Okay, understood? Clear? Can we move further? Any doubt? Quickly give your response. Any doubt? Okay, so Gautam is saying that, sir, I think a former is a piece of insulator between which insulating plates are kept. So Gautam, let's understand these things. These plates are placed over one another. Okay, so we are placing these plates to one and another with some insulating material, and these insulating materials are used to stop the leakage between one plate to the another plate. So that flux is linked with the primary to the secondary side. So when you use some insulating material in between these plates, that flux will not leak with one plate to the another plate. Okay, Gautam, have you understood? Clear? Any doubt till now? Quickly give your response. So, okay. Let's understand this. The copper wire is used to construct the field of exciting coil. The field coil of all the vowels are connected in series such a way that when current flow through them, the adjacent pole attain opposite polarity. Okay, so this is the construction for your exciting coil. So this is the armature winding. We have discussed this lap winding as well as a wave winding. Okay, now what is commutator? Okay, the commutator which rotate with the armature in cylindrical shape, it connects the rotating armature conductors to the stationary external circuit through brushes. Okay, it convert the induced alternating current in the armature conductor into unidirectional current in the external load circuit in DC action, okay, or DC generator action, where it convert the alternating torque into unidirectional continuous torque produced in the armature in the motor. So what is the main purpose of this commutator? The main purpose of this commutator is to convert one form of energy into another. Okay, so it will convert the, as you can see, it convert the induced alternating current in armature conductor into unidirectional current in the external load circuit of a DC generator action, where it convert the alternating torque into unidirectional continuous torque produced in the armature in the motor action. Okay, now come to the next point, brushes. What is this, what is the use of these brushes? So the brushes are pressed upon the commutator and form the connecting link between the armature winding and the external circuit. Okay, the pressure exerted by the brushes on the commutator can be adjusted and is maintained at a constant value by means of a spring. It can be used to provide lubricating effect and commutating surface. Okay, what is the end of housing? End housings are attached to the end of the main frame and provide support to the bearings. Okay, so what is the bearings? The ball or rolls bearings are fitted in the end housing. The function of the bearing is to reduce the friction between the rotating and stationary part of the machine. So where you find this bearing? In most of the rotating parts where your shaft is fixed, and with the help of these bearing your wheel is moving. So this bearing is present in fan. Yes Gautam, you are right, this bearing is present in fan. In all two wheelers this bearing is also present. Okay, so when your wheel is moving, so this bearing will rotate outer part of your wheel. Okay, clear? Any doubt till now in rotating part? Yes Pankaj, you are right. So this bearing is used in rotating part. So shaft, what is shaft? The shaft is made of mild steel with a maximum breaking strength. The shaft is used to transfer mechanical power from or to the machine. Okay, so this shaft is using in the rotating part. Okay, so working principle of DC motor, we will discuss this working principle in the next session. Okay, so anything related to the construction part you have not understood, we will explain those part in this session. Only 3 minutes are left, so all the doubts related to the construction part you can Parth is saying that, sir, please share this PPT or make us visible. So Parth, wait a minute. I think all the PPTs are visible. I have made all the PPT visible. Sir, use of Interpol. Sir, how changing and binding affect the motion of a motor in DC? So Pankaj, this concept comes when we will discuss the working principle. Okay, in working principle we will explain how these interpoles are used for the rotation of your inner part of a motor. Okay, so that how this shaft is going to rotate, okay, with the help of these interpoles. Okay, so we can see this in next session. Okay, today in the last lecture we will discuss the working principle. Okay, sir, only shaft part will move and rest all are stationary in the motor. So there is an armature winding, okay, and commutator is also present. So when your shaft is moving, so with the help of that shaft is connected to that commutator, okay, so that commutator will change that current into the mechanical part. Okay, so we will discuss the working principle in the next lecture, in today's lecture only. Okay, so Parth is saying that it is not visible. So chapter number 4, Parth, this is the presentation, this is the content page. You can see from this content page all the contents are already shared. Okay, so from my side they are visible to you, visible to the student. Okay, so you can see from here all the contents from my side are visible to the student. It is visible but not accessible. So okay, so you can give your email ID. I will forward to you right now. Okay, any doubt till now?